bust it. Try to do what those ladies tell us. Get shot down cause you're overzealous. Play hard to get, females get jealous. Okay, smarty, go to a party. Girls are scantily clad, are showing body. A chick walks by, you wish you could sex her, but you're standing on the wall like you was Poindexter. Next day's function, high class luncheon. Food is served in your stone cold munching. Music comes on, people start to dance, but then you ate so much you nearly split your pants. A girl starts walking, guys start gawking. Sits down next to you and starts talking. Says she wanna dance cause she likes the groove. So come on, fatso, and just bust the move. Someone could cure your lonely condition. Looking for love in all the wrong places. No fine girls, just ugly faces. From frustration, first inclination is to become a monk and leave the situation. But every dark tunnel has a light of hope. So don't hang yourself with a celibate rope. New movie showing, so you're going. Could care less about the vibe you're blowing. Theater gets dark just to start the show. Then you spot a fine woman sitting in your row. She's dressed in yellow, she says hello. Come sit next to me, you fine fellow. You run over there without a second to lose. And what comes next? Hey, bust the move.
Welcome to this week's edition of Jaguar News. I'm Adriana Torres.
And I'm Tayu Lamar.
For our first story of the year, Jaguar News reporter Valerie Flores brings you Jagtastic news on what the new principal and assistant principal have to say about our school.
When presented the opportunity to be the principal here at South, I was all over it. I had heard nothing but great things about the students here, the teachers here, our parents, our community. And so when I was presented the opportunity to serve as principal here at South, I really jumped to it because I really had heard a lot of good things about our school. I would tell you two challenges we currently have is just encouraging our students, reminding our students to wear their IDs. And with that particular issue, that challenge, right, I have reminded all of our staff, our assistant principals, our teachers, our security personnel, our secretaries. I've reminded the adults on our campus, and myself included, that it's important that we wear our ID to model that for you guys as students. The easiest part about my job is working with kids, interacting with kids. I've always felt like I've had a unique kind of niche in the area of just working with kids, interacting with kids. I was a high school government and economics teacher for 10 years and never really had any behavior problems or, you know, writing referrals and things like that. Always worked real well with kids. I've always gotten along with kids. And as a coach, I was a football coach, I was a basketball coach, I was the head track coach at Peoria High School. And I became really skilled at just getting kids to do things, to accomplish things that they normally wouldn't do. And so having that that skill and the opportunity for me to do that comes very, not very easy, but pretty easy for me to do as I move forward with what I'm doing now.
One thing that I enjoy about the school so far is how welcoming the students and staff have been, and a lot of students who I don't know coming up and introducing themselves. And I had one student who just came and said, you know, I know you're new to the school, I wanted to introduce myself, and I thought that that was great. And so I've definitely received a warm welcome, and no one's giving me the cold shoulder. It's been a really easy transition. One change that I would like to see is, that's a good question. I know student-wise, and I think that you're going to talk about problems as well, but would love to see all students wearing their IDs at all time. And I get the feeling that IDs have to do with it's not cool to have my ID on, but I wear mine too. And I don't think students recognize the safety issue with student IDs, that it's our way of telling who's supposed to be on campus and who's not. So we need staff wearing IDs as well, because if there's an adult on campus and they don't have an ID or a visitor badge, then that's a safety issue. Are they supposed to be on campus? And so the idea of IDs has to be more important than the style, you know, that they don't look cool to have your ID on.
Now that you got more information about the principal and the vice principal, make sure to stop by and say hello. I am Herman Gutierrez reporting for Jaguar News.
It is great that the administration is ready for this new school year.
I'm really looking forward to the changes around the corner.
Not only do we have new administration, we also have new teachers. Jaguar News reporter Blanca Ramos found them to introduce to you.
Hi South Mountain, my name is Salisa Allers and I'm really excited to be a new Jaguar here.
Go Jags!
What a fun bunch of teachers.
Right, I'm excited to have a couple of those teachers guide my classes. Congrats to Dr. Palacios for being featured on social media last month for her contributions to excellence for Hispanics.
Shout out to Ms. Palacios and Mr. Sheikh for winning the Most Valuable Teacher Award. Keep on doing what you're doing, and this year will be a home run. The Random Acts of Kindness Club sure is racking up a lot of members. Here's Jaguar News reporter Sarah Cowherd with information on quite possibly the nicest club at school.
Pod 68 is usually very empty during lunchtime at South Mountain High School, but not on Tuesdays, when the Random Acts of Kindness Club meets, with a sign-up sheet and pin ready for anyone who may want to join.
I think that our school needed something positive to do here on campus and to be more involved with the community.
I created the RAK Club, which stands for Random Acts of Kindness, so that we could do community projects and do good things on campus. The perception of the students and the community is important to me. Is I'm a product of the community. I grew up down the street. I went to South Mountain High School and I still live down the street. So what people think of the students is important to me. And people often think of students in our school, they don't think very positively of them, so I am trying to change that. Our first project's gonna be doing blessing bags, so we're collecting small perishable items to put together for the homeless to help donate them. I'm collecting them in our room. There'll also be a box in the teacher mail room.
I talked to club president Alexis Rosales about her leadership in the club and how it's given her insight into her school.
The RAK Club actually means a lot to me. It's a way for me to show my kindness, and not only my kindness, but to be able to lead the rest of the representatives who want to show their love and kindness to the rest of the world and the rest of our community. And the leadership that I hold, it allows me to not only learn from the responsibilities that I hold, but to learn from those around me and to learn just what amazing individuals our campus actually has. We get so caught up in our lives that we don't all show it to others around us. And I think that RAK Club is crucial to some of us to realize, hey, we don't always do this the right way we should. Or hey, maybe we should have been kinder to this person on the day we were having a bad day. And so that's why I think it's the most important club that I'm a part of.
If you're interested in Random Acts of Kindness Club, make sure to go talk to Ms. Cervantes. I'm Sarah Cowherd with JAG News.
If you think you would like to join, please seek out to Ms. Cervantes in the Visual Arts Building.
You can also donate items to their clubs for their blessing bags.
Stay tuned. After the break, we have sports, information on community service, and a challenge to our viewers.
What's up, y'all? This is Rashad, Fireworks Photography. All right, let me tell y'all a secret. I work at about 15 schools. The South is my favorite. Don't tell nobody, please.
We can do it! You can do it!
Running straight back to the dealership. Me, I'm in my spaceship. That's right, I work for NASA. This FNH is not a fraud. Call that bitch my bodyguard. Call that bitch your bodyguard. Yeah, that's my bodyguard. Wear a lot of jewelry. Young don't do security. What's whiter than a napkin? Harder than a...
What are you wearing?
What are you talking about?
What you mean? Look at you. Your goodies are showing.
It's fine.
Your goodies are showing.
It's fine.
No, it is not.
Yes, it is.
You gotta be like me.
But I went throughout the entire day without getting dress coded.
Oh, you finna get dress coded now?
I'm not.
I'm gonna tell. Miss, there's a student outside. She's not in dress
code. You a snitch, man. Shut up.
Tai, do you have other clothes to change into?
No.
You know you're gonna have to go to the dean's office for dress code.
God. Shut up.
Come here, let's fill out a pass.
Whatever.
Should be in dress code next time.
Okay, I got you.
I'm disappointed.
If you don't want that to happen to you, make sure you're in dress code.
Welcome back.
Here is this week's stats on fall sports.
I'm Tai Lamar, and I'm bringing you this week's sports segment. Like all the fall sports teams are taking out to a great start.
Yeah, but remember to come out and cheer for your favorite teams too.
Next, we are going to show you the dates and deadlines for the upcoming SATs and ACTs. This year, a requirement at South is that you have to have 10 hours of community service in order to pass advisory. Jaguar News reporter Blanca Ramos asked students their thoughts and feelings on community service.
To me, community service means a way to give back to the community and to offer yourself to help out in the community.
Community service means to me that you volunteer without pay.
Well, community service means to me volunteering in your community without being told to. Yeah.
Community service means, you know, helping out around the school anywhere just because you want to.
Community service means that you're taking time to help others and do other activities other than academic activities.
Helping out the community, doing nice things for others while getting paid for it. Exactly, yeah, doing things for free.
I think that it's something they should do, but I think, yeah, a lot of people are angry about it.
It is something they should do because community service helps a lot of people.
It gets people involved in their community and it gets people to work hard.
Community service is something that you should be able to, you know, not need to feel like you have to do it. I don't think that people should be have to force to be doing community service to graduate.
40 hours is not a lot.
Okay, I think it's good because when you apply for colleges and stuff, it actually helps you out in the long run. It gets you prepared for whatever, something in later on.
I haven't done any community service hours.
Zero.
Don't exactly know how many I have right now, but I have a lot because I do taxes with my mom.
I don't know how many community service hours I have.
I have like 15 hours of community service and by club meetings and volunteering for different activities.
20 hours community service in? Zero.
It's kind of hot outside, so like, you know, like there's community service where you have to like pick up trash and I don't think that would be very fun.
Yeah, I find community service very fun. It makes me feel better to help others.
Yeah, I think I will probably enjoy doing community service.
It's all right. Like, it brings joy sometimes.
It sounds like it could be fun, but then again, I'm wrong about most things, so.
I think it will be kind of difficult because I'm mostly busy all day and there's homework and.
No, it will not be hard because there is a lot of opportunities that the school offers for you to gain community service hours.
The only reason for me it would be sports because like it takes up a lot of time.
Life could happen, like all of a sudden you could get sick and all of a sudden you can't do no community service.
You could die.
Do community service at St. Vincent de Paul, St. Mary's Food Bank.
It's here at South Mountain. You can just join a club and you can earn community service hours by going to the meetings.
We actually have put together some guidance for our advisors. This gives teachers ways that they can support students on community service, and then also some things for students that they can do on community service, some suggestions. If you go to volunteermatch.org, you can find community service ongoing in Phoenix.
No, you should join a club based on what you like.
It's a very good reason to join them. It gets you working hard.
Important to also get a scholarship because, you know, it'll help you later in getting into university or college and paying for it.
No, I do not know how important it is to do community service for scholarships.
I mean, community service can go anywhere. It's really great.
It's important because colleges look at students that are more social and more well-rounded other than students that don't participate in no activities.
Well, no, I'm not going to college.
Doing community service helped me not break the shyness and help me with my communication skills.
Responsibility, respect.
How to fix doors, how to fix latches, how to make a house.
You know? Students will find a real passion that's going to encourage them to get involved more. Maybe they'll find a passion for after high school, for college, or for a job. Only good things can happen as you get out and get more involved in some of the amazing organizations that are out there.
Make sure you get your hours this year. This is Blanca Ramos reporting for JAG News.
I think it'll be easy to get the 10 hours before this year ends and the 40 before I graduate. How about you?
I don't have any community service hours yet, but I'm excited to give back to the community.
Seniors,
There will be ASU visitation dates for you to talk to the counselor from ASU, Ms. Kwan. Here are the visitation dates that will be held in the counseling office here at South Mountain, where you can also sign up from 11:30 a.m. to 1 p.m.
This year, Jaguar News is going to be bringing you student challenges to get our audience engaged with our show. Here's our first challenge. I'm Adriana Torres, and this is this week's challenge. So the sentence is, the peaches are blue. The peaches are blue. The peaches are blue.
Pictures?
The peaches are blue.
How are you?
The peaches are blue.
Said the. The? Okay.
The peaches are blue. The peaches are blue.
The peaches are blue.
The peaches are blue.
The pigeons are blue.
The peaches are blue.
Blue? Something blue. The something is blue.
The peaches are blue.
You like Taco Bell?
The peaches are blue.
Say that again.
The peaches are blue.
You like donuts?
The peaches are blue.
Michael Jackson is a boy?
The peaches are blue.
Kevin Hart like 4 feet.
The peaches are blue.
What? You say Young Metro Boomin?
The peaches are blue.
The pictures are coming?
The peaches are blue.
The beaches on the... You said something about a beach?
The peaches are blue.
The peaches? Like James and the Giant Peach? That what you said? Oh, I got it right?
The peaches are blue.
I want to punch you?
The peaches are blue.
Do it again.
The peaches are blue. The peaches are blue.
I don't... Do it again.
The peaches are blue.
The school? I don't know.
The peaches are blue.
Do it again.
The peaches are blue.
The bitch is over.
The peaches are blue.
Pick the shit, what?
The peaches are blue.
Pictures are blue.
The peaches are blue.
The pictures are blue.
The peaches are blue.
The pigeon?
Peaches.
Pigeon?
Peaches. Peaches.
Benches?
Peaches.
What?
Peaches.
What? Hey, can I play?
The peaches are blue.
The peaches are blue?
The sky is black.
The child is black.
The sky is black.
Hey, I have what? To
the sky is black.
The child is black.
The sky is black.
I don't know what you said.
The sky is black.
I feel slow.
The sky is black.
The child is black.
The sky.
Okay.
The yellow school bus.
The yellow what?
School bus.
Tobin?
School bus.
Tobin's.
School bus.
School ends.
School bus.
School bird.
Bus.
Almond.
School bus.
Tomment.
School bus.
School boy. School bus.
I'm Adriana Torres, and that was this week's challenge.
I cannot wait to see what next week's challenges will be.
Well, that brings us to the end of our first show of the season.
Please, make sure to follow us on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and Snapchat.
See you again in 2 weeks.
Goodbye.